Okay, so today we are looking at a brand new game, a game I'm guessing many of you have never heard of, and it's a game by the end of this video you're probably going to be interested in. The game is called Exe Killer, and to quickly describe it, imagine Red Dead Redemption crossed Cyberpunk crossed Back to the Future. Yep, that is it. How's it going, guys? My name's DPJ, and if you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really helps out, and if you like what you see and want to see more, be sure to subscribe. Okay, so not too many days ago, we got our first trailer for the game, Exe Killer. For the few that have seen it so far, like myself, we are very excited. The trailer I will play now for those who haven't seen it, and then we'll get into all the details we know so far on this game.
In a world where there are no rules, the only law that matters is a loaded gun.
Go ahead, make my day.
It's not about taking somebody's life. It's about taking their souls.
Money for blood. That's peculiar, profession.
Sometimes I kill for money. Sometimes I kill for justice.
Your next target, Johnny the Wireman, wanted alive, paying double. Last seen somewhere in Jacobstown area.
He's not going anywhere.
Bounty hunting is a hell of a business.
Make you an offer, which I'm sure you won't refuse.
So yes, looks pretty cool, as I'm sure you would agree. So this game is created by a Polish company called Paradox Studios. It's a single player action adventure, retro futuristic open world game. You can see there are loads of influences from other games here. The CEO of Paradox Studios says himself, "We are fans of westerns, post-apocalyptic but at the same time dark sci-fi, cyberpunk and retro futurism." From mixing these genres, Exe Killer was born, and you guys can truly see that within this trailer. So the world of Exe Killer itself. Here we experience a dystopian alternative reality where the apocalypse has already happened. 20 years ago, the Great Fire Disaster set most of the world on fire, causing mass extinction and destruction of life and Earth. Only 30% of mankind has survived. Only a few spots on Earth are possible to live. As the governments failed, corporations took control. The world is plunging into chaos and anarchy. Welcome to New York in 1998. So yeah, a futuristic game yet set in the past in regards to our year. It literally doesn't make sense to a point of it just making sense. So we as the player within New York of 1998, you are an Exe Killer, a futuristic bounty hunter. Your main goal is collecting souls, biochip components which gathers information about its owner and also controls them. Chips are produced by one of the biggest corporations that rule the new Earth. Without soul, you simply don't exist. I'm getting all kinds of vibes here, references from movies, other games, so much more. Now we hunt down outlaws in this game's vibrant world. We kill them, bring them to justice, or even set them free, the choice is ours. But we have to choose carefully, as the actions and choices you make will determine how the player-driven story unfolds. We can augment skills, use a variety of gadgets, sneak past enemies, use the environment as your advantage, or talk your way out of troublesome situations. We can travel across diverse regions inside your trusty vehicle, experience fascinating journeys through post-apocalyptic landscapes, survive in the wasteland, fight against roving gangs of bandits, harsh weather conditions like radioactive sunstorms, and much, much more. Now, as of right now, guys, the game is coming to Steam only we can add it to your wish list. There is no publisher backing right now, and Paradox being a super small studio to a point of people, a two-man studio, it's unlikely now we will see this on console. But things can change before release. I mean, there ain't no release date set in stone as of right now, so there's plenty of time for things to change. So yes, this is what we know so far, guys, about Exe Killer. As soon as more details drop, obviously I will have you covered right here on my channel. This is definitely a game up my street, well, from what we've seen so far. Let's just hope it doesn't fall victim to the same problems many games have had over the past few years, mentioning no names. But on that note, the end of the video has arrived. If you enjoyed it, leaving a like really helps out. If you're new around here and want to see more, be sure to subscribe. And if you never want to miss a video I upload, you can turn notifications on by hitting that bell button. But guys, thanks as always for stopping by, and hopefully I will see you on that next one.